Welcome back. On last video, we have seen how to SSH into our EC2 Linux instance by using PowerShell CLI command. And on this video, we will see how to connect to Linux instance using Putty, a free SSH client for Windows. Here we need Putty to install on our local computer. So first, we will download the latest version of Putty from the Chrome browser. We just need to search Putty download, and on the first top page, we will get it. Click on the link to download the latest version, and once it is downloaded, then we'll go to install it. Putty does not natively support the private key format for SSH keys. Putty provides a tool named PuttyGen, which converts keys to the required format for Putty. We have to convert our private key, that is .pm file, into .ppk file. Alright, here we have installed it successfully. Let's start to convert the private key. From the start menu, we will choose Putty, then PuttyGen under all programs. Under type of key to generate, we'll choose RSA. If your version of PuttyGen does not include these options, then choose SSH1 or 2 RSA. Choose load. By default, PuttyGen displays only files with the extension .ppk. To locate the .pem file, we have to choose the option to display files of all types. Then we will select our .pem file for the key pair that we specified when we launched our first Linux instance and choose open. PuttyGen displays a notice that the .pem file was successfully imported. Now we will go to choose OK. We have to save the private key now. PuttyGen displays a warning about saving the key without a passphrase. So we'll go to choose yes. We have to specify the same name for the key that we use for the key pair, that is linux server.ppk, and choose save. Putty will automatically add the .ppk file extension. The private key is now in the correct format for use with Putty. We can now connect to our Linux instance using Putty's SSH client. Now connect to our Linux instance by using the following procedure. We need .ppk file that we created for our private key. Now we will start Putty. How we can start it? Let's see. From the start menu, choose all program, that is Putty and Putty. Okay. Now in the category pane, we will choose session and complete the following task. In the host name box, we will put here the public DNS to connect using our instance public DNS name, or can connect by using public IP address. Like here, I am using public IP address. So we will put here ec2-user@13.126.83.49 and the port 22 and the connection type will SSH. We will save it as Linux server instance and save it. Okay. We will try to open it, and here it is given security alert that server's host is not cached in the registry. We have to add the key to Putty's cache so it will carry on connecting. So let's cancel it for now and start the Putty again. Here we will go in the category pane and expand connection, expand SSH, and then choose AUTH. Choose browse. Then select the .ppk file that we generated for our key pair and choose open. We have to save the session information for future use. Under category, choose session. Under name for the session in saved sessions, and then choose save. Finally, we can open it as we have connected to this instance first time. So that Putty displays a security alert dialog box that asks whether you trust your host to which we are connecting. We can choose yes. A window opens and we are connected to our instance successfully. Here you can see that Amazon Linux to AMI. Alright, now we are into the EC2 Linux instance, and we can check here whoami command to see that it gives the answer. Yes, it gives the answer that is EC2-user, the Amazon Linux instance user. Right, here we can see that the private IP address as well. Okay. Now we will ping google.com and are getting reply successfully. Alright guys, we have done with this video now, as we have seen how to SSH into EC2 Linux instance using Putty, and what is the requirement for that, and how to follow the steps in an easy method. See you guys on my next video. Till then, have a great day and bye bye.